Hello friends, I am Dr. Neha Taneja. So in my last video, we have discussed about cohort study in detail, about what type of study design it is, the strength of association, the advantages, disadvantages. We understood that topic with the help of an MCQ. Today again, we are trying to do a new study design, which is case control study, and we try to understand this also with the help of certain MCQs. So, just to make you understand ki case control study hota kya hai, I put forward for you an MCQ. This was asked in one of the AIIMS paper. The question is, a study compared 150 children with a particular disease with 300 disease-free children to examine past experiences that can contribute to development of the illness. What kind of study it is? Cohort, cross-section, case control, clinical trial. Now, this type of question will definitely come whether in post-graduation entrances examination or FMGE, it's very important. So, you need to see here, you need to look at the question, and here you can see that, okay, your study compares 150 children with a particular disease with 300 children, disease-free children to examine what? The past experiences. So, from this you know that in your study you have two groups, okay? One are the cases, or the first group are those who have the disease, okay? Those who have the disease. So, those who have the disease will become the cases, and how many are they? 150, okay? With a particular disease, with 300 disease-free children. So, your other group is who? Those who do not have the disease. Okay? So, they will be who? They will become as controls. Okay? So, they are 300. Now, what are you doing? You are asking, or you are examining them for past experiences. Past experience matlab, examining for past experience matlab, you are examining them for a particular exposure. Okay, that may contribute to the development of the disease, which means you are starting your study with cases and controls, and you are going back in time to see their past experience, to examine their past experience. That means you are going back in time to examine or determine an exposure, okay, that might have led to this outcome. So here what does this indicate? That you're starting with cases and control, you go back in time to see how many were exposed and not exposed to a particular design, so to a particular exposure. So what is this? This is a retrospective study design. This is called as retrospective. If you remember, in a cohort what you were doing, we were starting with a cohort, people who were exposed to a particular exposure like smoking, and those who were not exposed, we were following them over time to see how many develop the disease, how many do not develop. So it was prospective, it was a forward looking study. Here what you are doing, you are going back in time to see how many were exposed to a particular exposure. Okay, so it is a retrospective design, or it is a, the second term it is a backward looking study. Okay, or you are going from what? You are going from that cohort is a cause to effect. This is a effect to cause study. Okay, so the answer here would be case control. Cohort study, I have told you, is a forward looking study. You start with the group, exposed, non-exposed, follow them over time to see how many develop a disease, how many do not develop. So it's not a cohort study. Cross-sectional is, you take a snapshot of a population at a particular point of time, the exposure and outcome are determined at that very point of time, but here, which is not in this case, so it is not a cross-sectional study. Clinical trial, everybody knows, we give an intervention, so definitely it's not a clinical trial. What is left? Case control, and by application of the design also, it's a case control study. Now, what does this mean, going back in time? Guys, this you might get confused with. What is going back in time? Going back in time doesn't mean that if you are in 2019, I will jump back to 1999. It is not possible. I would go collect the information from past records, okay? Or I would go and ask these cases and the people residing there, okay? So, we go back in time to collect information from, but that is the meaning of going back in time. That could be population records, registries, hospital records. Okay. So the first answer, so this is the basic design. I will again draw it for you. In a case control study, what you have, you start with cases and control. Cases are those who have disease, who do not have disease are controls. You follow them over, you go back in time to see how many were exposed to an outcome and how many were not exposed. Okay, that is why all these terms. So they can ask you any of these terms and ask you which type of study design it is. Moving ahead, one of the most important things is the selection of controls in a case control study. Okay, who should be the controls? So I put it down for you. Ideally, a question comes that what is the maximum number of controls you can select per case? Guys, please remember, maximum is up to 4 controls per case. But again, if the expense or if the cost of selecting cases and controls are equal, okay, then you can also restrict to 1:1. This is for, basically this happens in larger studies. For smaller studies, you can have 4 controls for up to 1 case. But if the cost of collecting cases and controls are equal, you can have 1:1. But not more than 4 controls, because then duplication arises. Second question, that who are these controls? Cases, we all know, are those who suffer from the disease. Controls are free from the disease under study. But what is important is that the choice of cases and controls must not be influenced by the exposure status. Okay, suppose we want to see, we have cases of lung cancer and cases who and controls who do not have lung cancer. We want to determine the exposure status with smoking. Now, smoking should not be the factor influencing our choice of cases and control. That is what this line means. Okay, next, who could be your controls? Your controls could be hospital controls. Okay, they could be neighborhood controls. Why neighborhood controls? Because you have similar socioeconomic conditions, similar state of living. Okay, relatives. Now, if a question comes, relative controls, relatives is controls, cannot be used in which form of study? So of course they could not be, they are not suitable in which, they are not suitable in which study, which type of study that you are doing, in genetic based studies. Okay, your relatives cannot be used as controls. You can also take them from general population, but again the problem of bias arises. Bias we'll be doing in detail in the other lecture. Now let's just try to sum up case control study by dividing it into advantages and disadvantages and also comparing it with cohort study. Remember, this is a very important university question and somehow or the other it's also put in an MCQ. Okay, so I've written it down for you that in a case control study, what is most important? Let's write CC case control study and just to compare it with the cohort study so that we have the recapitulation also. Okay. So in a case control study, what happens? Both exposure and outcome have occurred, right? You start with outcome is your disease that has already occurred. They are the cases. Your controls are those who do not have the disease. You go back in time to determine the exposure status. So both exposure and outcome have occurred. In comparison to cohort study, what happens? That, to put it with a blue pen, the outcome has not occurred. Okay, what are you doing? You are starting with exposed, non-exposed, following them over time to see how many develop the disease, how many do not develop. That means outcome has not occurred. Another difference or a point of case control study is obviously it's easy to carry out. We had done in a cohort study, it's difficult to carry out. Okay, then this is rapid and inexpensive. This is very expensive, a cohort study, because why? There is a follow-up period of longer durations. So obviously it becomes expensive. Next, in a case control study, there is no risk to the subject or there is minimum ethical problems, right? Because cases have already occurred. So the question of ethical problem is not there, right? You just have to go back to the previous records and collect the data, right? Here what happens, there is an issue of ethical problems, right? Because what is happening, we are following up the people. Okay, then here what happens, there is no loss to follow up, right? This is indication of attrition bias, right? So there is no attrition bias. Here what happens, the problem of loss to follow up arises, right? Because because it's a longer duration study, in a cohort study people might drop out, right? So that problem arises. So these are the advantages of a case control study in comparison to a cohort. Everything that has an advantage will have a disadvantage. What could be the disadvantage in a case control study? Of course, the selection of appropriate control groups. If we do not select appropriate control group, if we select controls that are influenced by exposure status, it will result in bias and it will compromise the validity of a study. That is why this is a disadvantage. That in a cohort study becomes an advantage because you're simply determining the development of a disease. You are just starting with exposed and non-exposed, right? Then another point is strength of association. Now, if you remember, I told you in my earlier video that for cohort studies, strength of association is determined by which variable? Relative risk. You remember, incidence of disease among exposed, non-exposed. Started with exposed, non-exposed, follow up to see how many develop the disease, how many do not. So here what you are calculating? Here you are determining the incidence of a disease, which is a stronger determinant of strength of association. Okay? You are starting with the cases and controls, so you can just give a relative measure of strength of association. You cannot determine the incidence. Okay? So here kya hota hai? You cannot determine the incidence. Okay? Here what you are doing, you calculate it by what is known as odds ratio. Okay, this we'll be discussing in a next video. Relative risk is a measure of incidence of a disease, which is a stronger determinant of strength of association. But in case control study, we cannot calculate the incidence of a disease. That is why it's a weaker measure of strength of association. Then there is an important problem of bias. Jaise yahan pe attrition bias tha in cohort study, loss to follow-up. Yahan pe which type of bias is there? We have what is called as recall bias. Okay, if you ask someone who suffered from suppose any cardiovascular disease, he or she will remember what exactly he or she has done. Suppose I might not remember exactly what is my what I was exposed to and such things. So there are factors. So there is a problem of recall bias. One thing I forgot to tell you that here, because this case control study is important to study what? Here, this is important in cases of rare diseases. Okay? Right? In a cohort study, you cannot study rare diseases because you start with exposure, non-exposed. Okay? But you can study multiple exposures and outcomes. In a case control study, on the other hand, what happens is you can study rare diseases. Jaise laborers, man lo, kisi factory mein kaam karte hain, there are incidents of some skin cancer is occurring. Okay, that is a rare outcome. That is a rare disease. So you can study that particular disease in the form of a case control. You just have to go back and see what the laborers were exposed to and what they were not exposed to. Right, so this is important about case control study, selection of controls, kaise hota hai, what is the important study design, why is it called retrospective, what are the other terminologies for it. Okay, don't get confused between a case control and a retrospective cohort. If you remember, I told you case control study, the exposure and outcome have occurred. In a cohort study, outcome has not occurred. So even in a retrospective cohort, okay, the outcome has not occurred. Suppose you're doing your study in 2019. Okay, you go back in time to see how many were exposed and how many were not exposed, and in 2019 you determine the outcome. Okay, the outcome has not yet occurred, but in a case control you have the outcome. So this was about case control study, the basic study design, the different terminologies, the advantages, the disadvantages, what is the most common bias associated with it. In my next class, I will in detail tell you about odds ratio and use an MCQ to solve that particular question also. I hope you like this video. If you have any comments, drop in the comment section below. Thank you so much.